So, continuing with the trade-off, the next the most important factor is the solidity. The solidity is the one of the most important parameters that can affect the performance of the straight blade vertical axis wind turbines or the horizontal axis turbine. The solidity is the ratio between the blade area and the turbine swept area. The higher number of blades means the solidity ratio will be high. So higher solidity ratios means that more starting torque has to be required. So more starting torque means that their operational speed will be lower. The turbine must run at high speeds in electrical power generation because the generator is more efficient in higher speeds. The more efficiency translates to lower weights and cost. So solidity is low and the turbine, when the solidity is low, the turbines can operate at higher speed. The same is the phenomena used in high speed two blade designs. Next is the use of upwind or the downwind configuration. The upwind configuration has the higher power yield and no tower shadow on the blades. The lower noise and the blade fatigue with smoother power output. So these are its advantages. However, the drawback which is associated with the configuration of upwind configuration, the rotor must continuously turn facing the wind, and heavy yaw mechanism result in higher and stiffer rotor. The next configuration is the downwind configuration. The downwind configuration, the power loss due to tower shadowing is more prominent. Also the free yaw system and blade can deflect away from the tower when loaded, reducing the shadowing effect. So this is the advantage that is associated with the downwind configuration. Also the drawback is that many yaw in one position for a long time, wearing out the certain carrying cables from the turbine. Also if there are bearings that are associated with that movement, the certain wind direction which is producing downward force is capable of degrading that bearing that is being accounted for that motion. The upwind turbines are more preferred over the downwind turbine design for the in the last recent years. The next is the horizontal and the vertical axis wind turbines. The horizontal axis wind turbines, the axis blade rotation is the horizontal with respect to ground, whereas in vertical design, the axis of a blade rotation is vertical with respect to ground. In horizontal axis windmill, they are considered cost effective wind turbine, and they are basically mostly used for installation purposes and commercial purposes. Also they are easy to control when we want to control them in the speed or direction or the windmill pitch control. So horizontal axis wind turbines are easily controllable as compared to the vertical axis ones. The vertical axis wind turbine are omnidirectional and they do not require the alignment with respect to wind direction as it is done with the horizontal axis turbines, wind turbines. Also, in vertical axis wind turbines, the ground installation of electrical gearbox and generator is necessary as compared to the horizontal axis wind turbines, where the generator is mounted on the top of the pole of the wind turbine. The drawbacks of vertical axis turbines are that they have difficult pitch control in high wind conditions and requires wires to produce support at the top and limits its operation in offshore farms because constant maintenance is required in this type of design.